Welcome back, everybody. My name is Prestige. Thank you so much for joining me on the channel. I have to let you guys know I'm sorry for not uploading custom zombies every single Wednesday through October. I was supposed to be uploading custom zombies, and unfortunately, I've just been really busy in my life, and I haven't had, like, a solid hour to just sit down and record zombies, because it does take a long time to record those videos and get those ready for you guys. So I apologize for that, but I do want to talk about something that was discussed over the past, I believe it was, like, 24 or 48 hours. I saw an article on CharlieIntel.com. I'll link the article down below. This is a really important thing for anybody playing last generation Call of Duty Black Ops 3, whether it's on the Xbox 360 or the PlayStation 3. I would just like to say one more thing before we get into it. I am not taking a stab at the Xbox 360 or the PlayStation 3. I understand that people can't afford to upgrade. I understand that people can't afford to do this, can't afford to do that, blah, blah, blah. I hear the comments 1,000 times every single time I make this type of video, but this needs to be said. I make this stuff because of people that are going to be playing these games. They need to know what they're getting into. They need to know what their $50 is going to get them, and their $50 is going to get them. Ready? Drum roll, please. 30 FPS. I know that a lot of people are like, what? Like, Call of Duty has always strived on having that 60 FPS or 60 frames per second. The most, like, smooth-looking multiplayer that you could possibly have. 30 FPS, aiming towards 30 FPS, is not a very good experience. Like, everybody always complains about frame rate drops and all of that type of stuff. Well, you're going to be experiencing this a lot, probably, on the last generation. So let's go ahead and move over to the article and talk a little bit about this. So Beenox Entertainment and Mercenary Technology are both working on Call of Duty Black Ops 3 for previous generation consoles. The developer was speaking to Develop Online, and they had to say this. This is actually coming from the creative director at Beenox, Thomas Wilson. He says, "I'd like to say that we tried to hit our target FPS, which is 60 FPS. It becomes harder when you're working on last generation platforms. We're basically looking more at something like 30 FPS, but still, the experience is very enjoyable, otherwise it's not Call of Duty." Now, something that happened a couple of months ago, actually like last month, was the announcement of campaign being removed from last generation completely. Now, with this announcement, I figured that all focus would be on the multiplayer aspect, but I think it's become so constrained on last generation because of lack of memory that they're very, you know, they're literally just squeezing by. Like, this 30 FPS or attempting to get 30 FPS isn't even guaranteed, so it might be bouncing, it might be, like, lagging, it might be, you know, frames dropping and stuff like that. So when they removed the whole campaign, Activision made a statement saying that they could not actually faithfully recreate the campaign experience that they were looking for. So that makes me wonder why this game is being made at all. And I know a lot of people are going to say, what the hell, Prestige? Like, come on, people still want to play it even if it's on PS3 or Xbox 360. This is a big deal. Like, if they faithfully can't recreate the multiplayer either with 60 FPS and everything that you've come to know and love, I mean, look at all the stuff that's already ripped out of it. You don't have your paint shops. You're not going to have theater mode. Like, there's no way in hell you're going to have theater mode. You know, you don't have your esports or arena modes. You have so much missing from the multiplayer that it's literally bare bones. And another thing that I would like to point out is there has not even been DLC announced or a DLC season pass announced for this previous generation. You might literally have the bare of bare bones here. So if you want to play, there you go. But at this point, I don't think that they can faithfully recreate the multiplayer either, even in 30 FPS. So this makes me really worried. I mean, I can tell you guys right now, guaranteed, there's no way in hell that there's going to be another Call of Duty game made on previous generation. Like, there's just no possible way after all of the stuff that we've seen removed so far. If there is, then I wouldn't even suggest doing it, because like I said before, we've seen what last gen was like on Advanced Warfare. A lot of people complained about that. Get ready to complain about this one. So this is just, once again, not taking a stab at last generation, simply reporting to you guys that are going to be stuck there. That's pretty much the only point of this video. You know, if you can't upgrade, I completely understand. You know, sometimes people can't afford it. Sometimes there's other situations. You know, sometimes people just don't have jobs or whatever, or can't save the money. It It doesn't matter at this point. I'm just reporting to you guys what you're going to be getting into if you end up getting this last generation version of Black Ops 3. So I would really appreciate if you guys could click that like button down below for this information. If you enjoyed, make sure to hit that subscribe button as well. Going to be doing some more awesome Call of Duty videos each and every day leading up to Call of Duty Black Ops 3. Once again, 15 days away. Let's get it. Until next time, everybody, I'm out. Peace.